Today is March 20th, 2016, and we thank you for taking the time out of your day to spend with the Greater New Hope Missionary Baptist Church International. Today's Holy Spirit messenger is Pastor Charles E. McDaniel. The Holy Spirit message is entitled, "The Elect and the Call. Let us not shrink from our possibilities," part 6. He will be coming from the King James Version of the Bible. The background scriptures will be Psalm 63, 1 through 5, Psalm 63, 6 through 11. Again, we thank you for joining us. Please open your hearts and minds to be fed and filled with the Word of God. Know that the Lord gives strength unto His people, and the Lord blesses His people with peace. Psalms 29 and 11. Again, your Holy Spirit message is entitled, "The Elect and the Call. Let us not shrink from our possibilities," part 6. And your background scriptures again will be Psalm 63, 1 through 11. "But the king shall rejoice in God. Everyone that sweareth by him shall glory. But the mouth of them that speak lies shall be stopped." That's Psalm 63 and 11. Thank you.
Yes, no. You miss my Lord have mercy. I hope you're focusing on the rock higher than we.
Amen, Pastor.
We cannot get above that rock.
No, we can't.
He is Yahweh's Savior.
Yahweh's Savior.
And all morning, you can go ahead, son. All morning, we have been talking about one thing. We got to focus on what it is.
Yes, Lord.
We cannot shrink from God's power. God is all powerful. God can do all things if we just be still sometimes.
Amen.
But I want you to focus on the fact that in these days and times, people are trying to get political power. They're trying to get all kind of stuff. There's only one power.
Amen. Make it plain.
And the minute we realize that God has all power, we need not shrink from any man, anything.
Amen, Pastor. Amen.
You heard what we want. What is it, man? Hey, come on. Hey, he can't do nothing at his best, but kill the flesh.
That's all he can do, Pastor, at his best. That's
but we must be mindful of the power of God. He said, you need to fear one who can kill both body and soul. Now let's go to Psalm 63, and we're going to start at verse 1 rather hurriedly. But I really want to focus on the new text first, because for some reason, we become wimps when we need not be a wimp. God, he don't give you a spirit of fear. He stands up saying, "Look unto the hills, which cometh your help." But Luke 10, I may have mentioned that, but I want you to see it. This is Yahweh's Savior's talking. And he said unto them at verse 18, "I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven." As when God kicked him out, said, "You got too big for your britches." Behold, now listen now. "Behold, I give unto you" what? "Power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." I want y'all to let that soak in and override what your flesh tells you now. Because God, he's given you that power, and how you want to use it, that's up to you. Now, y'all hear what I'm saying? Not the serpent, tread on serpent. Now, don't go out and grab no snake. Now, he ain't talking about that. He's talking about, if you live for me, hey, you can tread on anything. You can read whatever you want to. And it's not going to invade your heart. You can look at it and understand that's not for me. Because it amazes me how we let the traditions of men creep in. Everybody's going to be calling, rolling eggs and all that. It's not, God has nothing to do. It's not even congruent with anything God is saying. God has given you the power when you release it, when you buy into what the world's saying, and take your child and see the bunny and all that. I ain't gonna call it quick like a rabbit and all that stuff. But God has given you power to look at this. And if you lack wisdom, notwithstanding, in this rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you. Did you know that? But rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. In that hour, Jesus rejoiced. What did he rejoice with? In spirit. And said, I thank thee, yes, O Lord. Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent, and hast revealed them unto babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good in thy sight. Now that's the bottom line. You have power. But it's not your power, it's God's power. Amen. And when you realize that, you will begin to do what is in Psalm 63. And we're going to read a little bit of pulpit speed because we have some other things God wants you to get in your heart. 63 verse 1. See, this is when David was in the wilderness of Judea. He says, O God, thou art my God. Is it your God?
Yes, sir.
Only one can answer that. He made it plain. Thou art my God. Early will I seek thee. My soul, not my flesh, my soul thirsteth for thee. My flesh longeth for thee.
Yes, Lord.
In a dry thirsty land where no water is. That's symbology now. You know, might have church doors open, but in a lot of them in the spirit. I can't judge anybody, but you should judge a tree by the fruit of that. And if they talk about Easter bunnies and all that, hey, I'm sorry, it's not in God's will. And the thing that really hurts God, everybody wants to get them a ham at Easter. And do you know every time you do that, if you read Isaiah 65, he said, he who eats swine flesh is like blowing smoke into my nostrils. So every time you do that, the enemy said, it blows smoke in your nostrils. See? But you don't understand it. These things mean something. We're talking about the triumphal entry into Jerusalem when he should be triumphantly entering into your heart. And if he does, then you don't mind laying down those palm leaves. You don't mind waving them because you know where your help comes from.
Amen.
Does anybody know what the Lord's saying? Now listen, every day, if you would just focus on what you do have and what you can do, then you'll realize you have power. Now, listen, second verse says, now my whole thrust in life is to see thy power and thy glory. So as I have seen where? Seeing thee where? In the sanctuary. This is the only place that's high and lifted up. And I know folks, I'm not going to get down on some folks. I'd be glad to see some of them come on Sunday, Easter Sunday, if they want to call it that. But it's not. It's Passover.
Yes, it is.
And resurrection.
Yes, it is, Pastor.
See, Jesus said, "What great desire I have to take this Passover." Now, the most incredible thing is, this is the day of the spring equinox. This is the calendar we live by. We're children of light. And if you count 15 days from this day, that's Passover.
Yes, it is.
Okay. They only serve Passover, Feast of Tabernacles. And what she just said about Pentecost. So we have to begin to understand God said on that day of Pentecost, you shall what? Receive power. After that, the Holy Spirit has come upon you. It may be ghost in your Bible. The translators got off the deep end, but it's Spirit. God is a Spirit. Okay? No. To see your power in the sanctuary. Because thy loving kindness is better than life. My lips shall what? Praise thee. That's what you've been doing all morning. You're decorating the fact that he's worthy to be praised. There's no, what else can you praise? Huh? That's going to prove, going to produce anything.
Yes, Lord.
You have to understand in Psalm 22, he says, I inhabit the praises of my people. So you shouldn't be sitting so quiet sometimes. Thus will I bless thee while I live. You mean you can bless the Lord? Yes. Yes, you can by telling him you love him.
Amen.
By telling him you believe his power. It is valid. It is real. And I will bless thee while I live. I will lift up my hands in thy name.
Yes, Lord.
Have you lifted up your hands sometime and just say thank you, Lord?
Yes, sir.
Huh? I'm telling you, just, because I know in my heart, you're the one that delivered me from whatever I'm going through. So I got to lift up my hand and say, thank you, Lord. Anybody know what the Lord's saying? Now look at the next. I want y'all to begin to get this in your spirit. It said, my soul shall be satisfied as with marrow and fatness, and my mouth shall praise thee with joyful lips.
Amen.
How many of y'all?
Amen, Pastor.
Got some joyful lips.
Y'all.
Most times, everybody got, some folk got their face puffed out. They get mad if somebody prayed too long, preached too long, or whatever. But if they go to a concert, they can sit there all night.
All night, Pastor. College. Yes. Yes.
And I don't know why everybody might thought it strange when they say wave the palm branches. But every time a rap star puts your hair and wave it like you just don't care. So you're telling everybody around you don't care. But you serve a God that cares for you. And he asks you, whatever I sow towards you, give it back to me. I only want your love.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Hosea 6:6, I want your mercy. And the fact, and I want you to understand my word. Don't be playing with something else that ain't going to produce anything. Now listen. Sixth verse. When I remember, get it in your spirit. When I remember thee on my bed and meditated on thee in the night watch. Why? Because thou hast what? Been my help. There's no doubt in my mind. See, when you get no doubt in your mind that whatever it is, he has been your help.
Mm-hmm.
Is anybody hearing what the Lord is saying? If he's not your help, you're in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, have mercy. Therefore, in the shadow, listen, This is so beautiful. In the shadow of thy wings will I rejoice. See, God spreads his wings symbolically. You're in his hand.
Amen.
The Bible says nothing can pluck you out of my Father's hand. That's Jesus.
Lord
have mercy. Y'all hear what it says? Nobody can take it because God is all powerful.
Yes, he is.
He has power that you can't even fathom. But it works for you. If you let it. Y'all hear what the Lord is saying? Eighth verse. My soul, listen, my soul followeth hard after thee. Does your soul follow hard after the Lord? Then you don't mind coming to Bible study. You don't mind coming to Sunday school. You don't mind coming to church with joy in your heart because you know the word of the Lord is going to speak to your power. What you need power in your life to make it just tomorrow. Y'all ought to be grateful that you got here, and it's by his power that you're going to get home.
Amen, Pastor.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Lord. Very good.
Now listen very closely. When you hear, see this symbol, thy right hand, that's God's power. Thy right hand upholdeth me. Mm. Are you listening, beloved? You can't shrink from that. You got to realize that it's got to be a part of your heart. I ain't talking about people regret. No, this is it. You must have the mark of God in your forehead. I mean, the word of God in your brain.
Amen.
And if you don't, please pick it up sometime. Say, hey, have you just woke up some morning? You might be feeling bad, but you just woke up and say, Daddy, I love you.
Amen.
And watch your whole day change. What the Lord is saying. Don't shift from, don't shrink from that. Don't let anybody take that from you because that caused all of the possibilities that God has for you when you would rejoice in the Lord, not in your circumstance.
Amen.
Does anybody hear what the Lord is saying? Hey, come on now. But listen, but those that seek my soul, there's only one person seeking your soul. To destroy it shall go into the lower parts of the earth. They gonna go to hell. Now hell ain't there yet, but they gone. See, Satan is the only one that's got a death sentence already on his life. God made him too. They shall fall by the sword. The sword is the word of God. Anytime somebody bothering you, you don't even have to say nothing to them. Somebody really messing with you,
that's right,
just read Psalm 37 in its entirety and watch things happen. They will look for their place and it won't be there no more. Have mercy.
Right.
They shall be a portion for foxes. In other words, little things will start eating up their life. They might look like they got money, but the Lord said they got a hole in their pocket. So fast as they making those ill-gotten gains, it's going right out their pocket. Y'all not hearing. But the king shall rejoice in God.
Will you rejoice in God?
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
How many of y'all would just simply rejoice in God? Everyone that sweareth, listen now, that sweareth by him shall glory. But the mouth of them that speak lies shall be stopped. Don't let them see you sweat, beloved.
He will.
You must understand that God controls everything. He told them, I'm going to harden the heart of Pharaoh. Go on out there and tell him, let my people go. And whatever he say against my people is the same thing going to come back on him. Somebody didn't hear what the book said. All right. But all these things, you must understand, God has given you power. The only thing, now it's not your power, it is his power. In order for us to begin to execute that power, let's go to Hebrews, the second chapter, and we'll go through 8 to 10. And I want you to really, really focus in on what the Word of God is saying. Thou, Jesus, Yahweh, Savior, or either Emmanuel, God with us, thou hast put all things in subjugation under his feet. For in that he putteth all things in subjugation unto him, he left nothing that is not put under him. But here's the key. But now we see, not yet all things put under him. In other words, God has so much power, you can't see all of it. I don't think you would if it might scare you if you did. Now, we got record on that because
Moses said,
they want to hear God just like you. He said, come on then. And when they went to the mountain, they heard that rumbling. They said, hey, you're going up there. We don't want no part of that.
Yes, they did, Pastor.
Anybody read the Bible? You don't have to fear God's power.
No, Lord.
He's not angry with you. But here's what we must do. It doesn't matter what you are going through.
No matter what,
if you can begin to get these few words in your spirit, the ninth verse. Okay, what's going on? But we see Jesus. Do you see him even
yes.
in the worst of times?
Yes.
But we see Jesus. But I'm ill. But we see Jesus. But I don't have a job. But we see Jesus.
Amen.
I don't care what's going on, but we see Jesus.
No matter what.
You hear what I'm saying? But we have to, I see Jesus. I don't care what it is. I'm going to see Jesus, and I'm not going to shrink from that. He told me, if I'll aid, look unto me. See, that's why I give y'all the word. I don't want you looking unto me, because I can't do nothing. But look unto Jesus, who can do all things. If you want to break it down, Yahshua, Yahweh Savior, the Anointed One. Now, who was made a little lower than the angels? Now, you must understand that we were created by God in the image of him and his angels. But now, what was he put on this earth for? For the suffering of death. That's what we're going to be celebrating, death, burial, and resurrection.
Amen.
But look, suffering of death, whatever. Crowned, even though he was crowned with glory and honor, he by the grace of God should taste death for every man. That's why you can't put nobody down.
Hmm?
God said for every man. Anybody hear what the Lord said? Now listen. For it became him for whom are all things, and by whom are all things, in bringing many sons unto glory, to make the captain of their salvation perfect through suffering. Amen.
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 It's time for us to give God the glory. It's his power. We're celebrating God's power. Because them Roman soldiers, they tried to seal the tomb. When God's power came, they fell like dead men. In other words, they got scared and passed out. I hear what the Lord's saying. And if you want to see somebody that got knocked off and got blind, Saul, just read Acts 26. And you'll see what Saul got his name turned to Paul because he met
the power of the Lord.
Anybody read the Bible?
Yes, sir.
Let's go to Psalm 55, verse 16 and 17. This is what you must do, beloved. You make it plain in your own heart. It said, as for me, I will call upon God, my creator, Elohim, and the Lord, Yahweh, my Father, shall save me.
Amen.
That's who made you, and that's who's going to have to save you.
Amen, Pastor.
If y'all don't mind me playing, just make a little rap out of that. But that's just the bottom line. When you see all caps, that's your Father. That is your Father.
Teach, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Now listen, it says, evening and morning, and at noon will I pray and cry aloud, and he shall hear my voice.
Thank you.
Don't ever think nobody. Just told you he'll hear you.
Yes, he did.
Mm-hmm. And he made it plain. I put all day long and sometime in the evening, or whatever time you want to call on me. I never sleep nor slumber. I don't care what's going on. I don't care. Sometime I may want to call my best friend. But they may not be home. The best they can do is hear my message. And that's if they want to hear it. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Huh?
Yes, Lord.
Everybody got some issues.
Everybody got some.
But when we look to the hills from which cometh our help, and ask God to hear, my cry. And he will. How can he do that? Because let's go to Psalm 62, 11 and 12. Now, I want you to hear this and really get it in your spirit, because it is God's power that resurrects Yahshua, his Savior, from the grave.
Yes, it is, Pastor.
And nobody can find his body, because he was translated. It take me a little while to begin this, but I want y'all to understand something. We're talking about the magnificent power of God. No other time in this earth age has they ever heard that a man was totally brought back from the dead but twice, when Christ at Lazarus come forth. Has anybody read in the Bible? And then Yahshua, Yahweh Savior, was raised from the dead as he said he would be.
Yes, he was, Pastor.
All right? Yes. Now listen. 11th verse. God has spoken once, twice have I heard this, that power belongeth unto God. Underline that.
Yes.
I know some folks say, well, that them politicians is powerful. Nah.
No, they're not.
God can punch the headlight out anytime he wants to. And I'm not trying to say God is evil, but say, hey.
We understand.
See, you got to understand something. All power belongs to God. I didn't say that. This is what the book said. That power belongeth unto God. Also, listen. Unto thee, O Lord, belongeth mercy.
Yes, sir.
For thou renderest to every man according to his work.
You mean
all he's saying, live by what thus saith the Lord. In other words, it doesn't matter whatever somebody is going through. You ain't went through nothing what Christ went through. And when we read this thing of David in Psalm 41, in the ninth verse, we're going to read on to the Lord, saying, I'm almost through for the day. See his own, this is a prophetic utterance about Judas being the one who would betray Christ. This was predicted many years, thousands of years before it happened. Look at the night. Yeah, my own familiar friend in whom I trusted, which did eat of my bread, hath lifted up his heel against me. That's David talking, but he's prophesying what is going to happen.
Yes,
they're going to be sitting at Passover.
Yes,
and he said, one of you shall betray me. And he said, the one that's eating and dipping in the sop. Well, I ain't got time, but I get happy on that. But see, you have to understand something. It doesn't matter what your best, whoever, your familiar friend, whoever it is. But thou, O Lord, be merciful unto me and raise me up. Now, he can say that because he raised up Jesus. What makes you think he can't raise up you? You have to understand, every one of us go through resurrections. You begin, when you study the word, you have a resurrection, a higher plane of thinking. It becomes rooted and grounded in your heart. And you ask God to raise me up that I may requite them. The etymology of that, I ain't even deal with them. You told me vengeance is yours. So take care of, Lord, that's what you told me. Uh-huh. So that's the only requite I'm going to do. I ain't going to be none of them. Now listen, when God takes care of business for you, you got to honor him for it. Okay. Don't be sitting up like you, well, I done do this, you know. I got through that one, boy. No, you didn't. But this is what you want to know in your heart. By this, I know that thou favorest me.
Amen.
Y'all don't think they heard what the book said, did it? See, you'll begin to see the goodness of God. And as you see it, and when someone who has gone through the similar thing, God will use you to raise them up. You're not doing it, but through you, when you will be a witness for God and allow him, because he's raised you up, you let that person know he can raise them up. And by this I know that thou favorest me. Why? Because my enemy, didn't say S on, my enemy doeth not triumph over me.
What
A, we're more than conquerors. What? Through him. So whatever you need to conquer, he can do it for you. All you got to do is be willing and obedient. Now listen, and as for me, thou upholdest me. But how does he do it? In my integrity. You cannot shrink from what you absolutely know what God said. It ain't no filibuster. You can't do like you do in the Senate.
Ain't no filibuster
with that. You can try to, you can't hold this off.
Yeah.
God said it. That settles it,
and that's it.
Now, if you want him to exercise his power through you, whatever you do, you must do it with integrity. He didn't say you had to be perfect, but when you know you done messed up, go before him. Don't be telling some friends, because they'll put it in the street. But when you go to him, and he tell you, you okay, I forgive you. My spirit will bear witness with your spirit that you have repented and you are a child of God. And sitteth me, listen, and sitteth me before the face, for before thy face. How do you gonna do that? thy face forever. That's what you want. You want to live in such a way that you have no doubt.
Yes, sir, Pastor.
As to where your power comes from and where you're going.
Amen, amen, amen.
Death has no more dominion over you then. Because they can't stop you. No matter what. He told you, I've given you power over the enemy. Lucifer. The dragon. All these officers he... Lord, hammer. And you will sit with me before thy face forever. Now what you mean? How can I be sitting before God's face forever? Have you not read that we have Yahshua sitting on the right hand of the Father, and he is making intercessions for you? He's keeping your face before the Father. Then he told you, I've given my angels charge over you. I told you that goodness and mercy will follow you all the days of your life. I told you in my song that I pour grace in your lips. Is anybody, my mercy, not till next, my mercy is renewed daily. Blessed be the Lord God of Yisrael, you can put your name there, from everlasting and to everlasting, amen and amen. They're the mind of that, and that's that. I don't care what you say, he say, whatever. You can conjugate them verbs all you want to, but God said it, that settles it. And
amen,
that's it. See, God don't want you walking as the world. They walking and they make up anything. See, the world is by precedent. God's law means what it says. 1 Corinthians 1:18. We got a few more verses and we through. Listen at this. For the preaching of the cross, that's what we're going to be celebrating, is to them that perish foolishness.
It is, Pastor. Make it plain. The word
says. Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Because they operate in Psalm 39:6, say, surely every man walketh in a vain show.
Well,
don't y'all see that?
Yes, sir.
Surely they are disquieted. In vain he heapeth up riches and knoweth not who shall gather them. See, if you're not under control, everybody, I've heard a whole lot of people, I want to hit the whole lottery. Okay, if you hit it, you ain't going to keep the money because you ain't had no wisdom to keep it. God has to be the one that's leading and guiding and directing you. 7th verse, and now, Lord, what waiteth I for? My lips, my hope is in thee. Excuse me, but I want you to get that. And now, Lord, what wait I for? I ain't gonna wait till the president, he can't do it. My hope is in thee. Deliver me from all my transgressions. Make me not the reproach of the foolish. Even though this person will try to put you down, saying, you one of them homophobics. And they come up with all kind of stuff. Tell them, have a nice trip. It's still an abomination. I can't change it. God said it, that settled it, okay?
Pastor, it is. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But unto them, listen, but unto, back in 1 Corinthians 18, but unto us which are saved, listen now, but unto us which are saved, it is what? It is the power of God. Are you listening, beloved?
Yes, sir.
1 Corinthians 2 and 5. I want you to underline these in your Bible. Whatever you do, it says here that your faith, I can't do this for you, that your faith should stand in the wisdom, should not stand in what? The wisdom of men. Excuse me, boy. I'm a little happy right now. You'll understand that one day when you stand up here. The faith, and that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, but what? But in the power of God. That's what we're celebrating. I mean, his power is immense. His power is unquestionable.
Yes,
we have to believe. Lord, have mercy. Can you give me four more verses? I'm through. I say I'm not through with this, but I'm through today. 2 Corinthians 12, 9 and 10. And when you understand this, you don't let nothing. That's why you hear pastor off say, don't let them see you sweat. If you messed up, you know how to go to God.
Amen.
That's what made David a man after God's own heart. He knew how to go to God and ask God to forgive him.
Yes, he did all the time, Pastor.
In 2 Corinthians 12, 9 and 10, he says, and he said unto me, I hope anytime you're in difficulty, he says, my grace is sufficient for thee.
Yes, Lord. It is, Pastor.
When you really get that in your spirit,
my grace,
because you know he will forgive you, then you just don't do certain things.
Amen, Pastor.
Because I know his grace is sufficient.
Yes,
I know his mercies are renewed every day. Listen, for my strength is made mature, not perfect.
The word etymology, that word is made
mature in weakness. Oh. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ might rest upon me. See, I want you to understand, when you're going through, it's not no power you can conjure up. Don't let your children think that little boy flying around on a broom can wave a stick and something's going to change. No. And neither of you calling no psychics, you're not going to change nothing.
Not at all, Pastor.
But you want the power of God to rest upon me. Now listen, listen. Therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities. That sounds a little crazy in the natural, don't it?
Yes.
But the etymology, you don't. You can take pleasure in because you know God's going to carry you through them. It doesn't matter how it looks to somebody else.
That's right, Pastor.
You know that you have your promise from God.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
That you're going to be all right.
All right.
I told you, there was times when I was going through a few things. I said, Lord, just take me. I'm tired of hurting. But I heard you say, you should live and not die and proclaim the word of the Lord. So I shut my mouth and kept on stepping. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? Hmm? And y'all know I've been through a little bit of something. But the same God that raised me up, raised you up. Can anybody think, woo? In reproaches, I don't care what nobody say about me. You shouldn't care either. Because they ain't got no heaven, no hell to put you in. In necessities, there's going to be some time, might be a little lean, in persecution, in distresses. But why? For Christ's sake. If they persecuted him, what makes you think they ain't going to mess with you? For when I am what? Weak, then am I strong. Get that in your spirit. That's God's power working through you. And I don't care whether you believe it or not. When I tell you the only time I'm totally pain-free is when I'm standing here giving the word of God.
Amen.
Now, if y'all saw my knees, I don't even know how I'm standing up, but his grace is sufficient. Okay, last two verses. Let's get focused on next week now. And that's 2 Corinthians 13, 4, and 5. I want everyone to say, if you got a Bible, say I'm there. And amen, because I want everybody, these my last two, and I'm in the spirit, said that, and that's settled, and I'm it. That's it. I want you to pay close attention to 2 Corinthians 13 and 4. Everybody got a Bible there? For though he was what? Crucified through weakness, yet he liveth by the power of God. Are you listening, beloved? That's how you got to live.
Amen.
For we also are weak in him, but we shall live with him. Why? By the power of God towards you. None of the pastors can do this for you. You got to do it. But fifth verse says, examine yourselves whether ye be in the faith.
That's right.
Prove your own self.
Yeah.
Know ye not that your own selves, how that Jesus Christ, Jesus a Yahweh Savior, the Anointed One, is in you, except you be a reprobate.
Yes, sir.
You can't fool God, beloved.
Shit.